Hi, and welcome to this Getting Started video with Hasura. In this video, we're going to look at a little bit of the differences for how Hasura operates versus a traditional GraphQL server. In the traditional GraphQL server, you're going to write, typically, resolvers. Resolvers are ways that you have defined the connections for your data, how does the data get resolved from the different underlying data stores, and you're going to then connect these into your schema. So when you write a GraphQL request, it comes into the actual server. That server is going to then federate that out to the different root fields that you've defined, and then those resolvers will fetch your data and make the requests. This is a very valid approach, and many systems work this way. The problem becomes that this isn't really saving us any time when it comes to building the majority of our applications, because we're simply taking writing REST endpoints and replacing that with needing to now write resolvers. Where we take a different approach at Hasura is that we use an engine approach. We've talked previously in another video, which you'll find linked in the bottom, about our metadata approach. When you take a metadata-driven approach that is a declarative way to define how does your system connect to your data sources, what we can do is utilize the underlying ability of an engine to say, I'm receiving a query that is asking for data that I know through the metadata is stored at my Postgres database. I will write an intelligent query at that data source, and it'll execute that at runtime. This is a really fundamental difference to how Hasura operates in terms of its approach to writing queries and resolving those queries. Now, there's a couple of other areas where Hasura takes a different approach. There is camp A in GraphQL that says always write custom resolvers that have to do with the actual application you're building. That's okay, but that does tend to make your API be rather specific to the actual application you're building. Camp B, which we believe is the correct approach, allows you to say, we're going to generate GraphQL accessors to your underlying data source. So regardless if you're building apps today, websites tomorrow, microservices next week, or whatever else you need to do for your projects, you'll have APIs that are understandable and shareable across all those services. Have a look at these generated endpoints that Hasura does for a typical Postgres project. Without having to do any work other than connecting my database, tracking my tables, and tracking the relations, through my metadata, I now actually can be able to do my inserts, my updates, my upserts, my deletes, without ever having to actually write resolvers by hand. These aren't actually resolvers under the hood. This is simply Hasura's way of understanding data accessing patterns to my underlying data source. This fits into the story that Hasura really believes in that what Hasura is solving for is a data access problem. What makes this really powerful is that when you take the data access solution that Hasura is providing, you are able to think about how does my data connect and not what is the boilerplate I need to write to make those connections. Defining those declarative styles, defining the declarative permission approach, allows you to go out and build really powerful applications. You may not actually be shipping any of these resolvers to the front-end clients. That would probably be bad to give delete many permissions to just any random visitor to your website. But what you can do is build really powerful services that you could expose through actions that would then allow you to be able to just build faster services faster. Let's have a look at what this concept really comes down to. When you go out to build a house, you're not first wanting to build saws and hammers and forge your own nails and cut your own lumber and head off to the build site. No, typically you would like to have all of those resources available to you from the infrastructure of today's modern construction environment. Taking those raw sources and tools, you can then build much faster than having to break out the forge and start hammering out some nails. That's the idea that Hasura is working with here, is when we take these generated accessors to your data sources, you can start to build faster for the services that really differentiate your business. And that's what we're talking about here, is differentiated code. We're not talking about you shipping data mapping to your client, we're talking about giving you the tools you need to build applications faster, more secure, without having to think about writing resolvers to solve all of these endpoints. Okay, let's have a quick architectural example of this. What we have here is our underlying data source, and we have our GraphQL engine. Now, whether I'm requesting from my client or I'm requesting from my microservice, I'm able to simply ask for data from that underlying data source, and it will be transformed at runtime by the engine. I'm not putting another layer in between. I'm simply giving it a transformer of that request to my data source through the GraphQL engine. This allows me to make very performant requests against my service. This allows me to also control my access and my permissions in a single place without having to worry about shipping environment variables and security risks across the board. All right, I hope that helped you understand a little bit about how Hasura is different when it comes to our GraphQL approach. In the next videos, we'll look at even more key concepts to help you understand how to work with Hasura.